Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to talk about the jurisprudence related to a startup visa program. What are the reasons of rejection and how can you take care of it beforehand when you know everything in place? It comes usually with a lot of experience and a lot of reading, research, analysis of the case laws that go on in the process. Secondly, I would also like to you to remind that because the entrepreneur PNP programs are right now shut because of the COVID-19 situation, the borders are shut and exploratory visits are not happening. So a lot many people are transitioning themselves from the PNP programs or from other programs to the startup visa program. So startup visa program is right now very hot selling, but also you have to be careful how you prepare your applications, what are the things that you have to take care of, and today we are going to discuss few of the rejection reasons. With me, I have Lavdeep here with me, who's also a fellow lawyer in the same and a partner with Ace Law Barristers and Solicitors, and also happens to be my husband. So today we are going to have a chit chat about the reasons for rejection. I hope you like it and it is informative for you. If you want to contact us, then you have to go into the link in the description box. Okay, so first let's start by understanding that what exactly is the startup visa program in a gist, and he's going to explain us that.
Hi guys, how are you doing today? And I hope everyone's feeling fine and safe in these unprecedented times. I hope this lockdown ends. I hope this the curfews end everywhere and people are out and about again. Anyway, so we were talking about a startup visa program. I want to tell you what startup visa program is basically. Startup visa program is if you have a good idea, if you have a good business idea, if it is already running and if you have something in place already, and you want to bring it to Canada, and on the basis of that you want to get a permanent residency.
Right, so the letter of interest, by that we mean in common parlance in the business language, we usually mean the commitment letter that you're going to get from the incubator, the angel investor or the venture capitalist, whoever is usually running the process. New ideas, they are actually sometimes, mostly they go into incubation, but if you have a running business, then that goes into with an angel investor on an accelerator, maybe somebody who's already interested in a running business. So whatever the designated organization may be, they do issue a commitment certificate, and if that commitment certificate would actually need to comply with a lot of ministerial policies. I think some of the points that you have to note in your due diligence documents and in your before your PR filing in that commitment letter, which later on we have seen becoming a reason of rejection. So we do not want cases in which when you have things in control in the business incubator stage, at that stage, and then you are later regretting just because of a mere mistake in the commitment letter. And that is why court cases we have seen do go to the federal court, and in the federal court a minute mistake just comes out like that and nobody can help you at that point of time. So it's always better to be very, very diligent at this stage of getting the commitment letter. And to know more about this ministerial policy, we will just highlight few of the points.
So let's start with letter of commitment. For the first and foremost thing jahan pe galti kha sakte log is the KYC. सो क्लाइंट की आइडेंटिटी हैज़ टू मैच विद अदर आइडेंटिटी डॉक्यूमेंट्स लाइक जैसे कहीं भी होता है फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन द बैंक्स इन एनी वेयर एवरी डिटेल हैज़ टू बी टेकन केयर ऑफ द नेम द एड्रेस द एज द डेट ऑफ बर्थ एवरी सेकेंडली वी हैव टू एस्टैब्लिश दैट यू आर एन एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ दैट बिजनेस तो ऐसा ना लगेगा दैट यू नो यू आर एट डिस्पोजल ऑफ समवन एल्स एंड यू आर जस्ट अप्लाइंग फॉर द सेक ऑफ इट जस्ट टू गेट इनटू कनाडा यू हैव टू बी एन एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ द बिजनेस.
Now let's come to the second point, which is like very important, and in few cases that we've read and we have known in the federal court that have gone to the appeal stage have actually been rejected because of structuring of the business was not very clearly given and defined in the due diligence documents. So if any in any case, if the immigration officer at the stage of reviewing your documents is not satisfied that you are an essential member or your structuring of the business was formed in such a way that the business can work without you also, then he has a reason to reject. And you do have to remember that one of the principles that they follow is that if they reject one essential person, then they're also going to reject all the members of the essential, whoever in the category of the essential persons are. So this is by way of a judicial precedent that they follow this pattern. So in structuring, you have to take care of your corporate shareholding agreements, which basically all the pre-incubation stage. You also have to take care of your due diligence agreement, which is a big, big fat file that goes to the incubator. So all the, and specifically your IPR, you have to really take care of the IPR needs of the Canadian entity. So all this walkthrough process of the pre-incubation stage has to be very important for you. Okay, so the third point is you might just face a reason of rejection can be there because you were given procedural fairness, but because you did not completely diligently give all your information, either there was misrep or there was some kind of information that was not given or some material evidence that the immigration officer might have received about you and did not disclose it to you. So in one of the case laws, like one of the person was a refugee in Canada before he had applied for a refugee status 4 years before, and his visa was rejected and he did not get his refugee status. So he did not disclose this information, which became a sign of red alert and a misrep, and hence the application for judicial review was also dismissed. Whenever you're dealing with an immigration lawyer or an agent, you want to test that person, you need to know that if the person is taking information about your immigration from all other countries, because that's very, very integral part of this application. Because you see, other things are really less, like your eligibility criteria otherwise is so less, your IELTS score is less, it's just CLB 5, your education system is not, it does not have to be very, very good looking or something like that. It can be a medium level 12 standard person onwards as well. So you just have to be careful of what they're actually looking. This is not business immigration, this is economic immigration. So they do see the impact of you coming into the economy of Canada. So guys, the last point, which is like the most important point, is your conduct. How are you conducting yourself related to this work visa, to this startup visa program and for this business, because you are coming on a work permit before. So you have to be very, very diligent in the situation where you've been granted a work visa and you still do not come. In some cases, you might be lucky that you get PR directly, but there are cases, and we know such cases, in which your PR might be rejected on the basis that you had a work permit option, but still you did not fulfill your role.
So guys, basically when you get a work permit, we advise you to come here in Canada, start the payroll running, do anything to fulfill the obligation to conduct this business. जैसे कुछ भी activities हो रही हैं business के अंदर, या आपका payroll चल रहा है, आपका certain transactions are happening in the business, so that the government knows when they're about to grant you the permanent residency, they get to know that you are doing something in furtherance of that business.
Right. So you don't want to render the immigration decision as invalid, because woh usually agar officer ko nahi aapse koi documentation milegi, if they ask at the PR processing stage that I want you to show something, that why are you essential to this business, then you should have certain documentation in place. So we do highly recommend that when you are issued a temporary foreign work permit, open or closed work permit, then you should come on that work permit in Canada and start rolling your business and start doing everything in furtherance of that. So guys, if you like this video, do hit the like button. If you want more such advice from us, do get in touch with us. If you want to know about the startup visa program and you want to apply for it, then the details are in the description box. Thank you and bye-bye for now.